The depression of men does not get sold. It has no market value.
Since you do not have a pair of tits to go along with your tears. Men are supposed to fix everything. Men are supposed to lift the burden, and we must be the emotional cushions for everybody around us. But when we go through something, all we have got is the person standing in the mirror looking back at us. Women do not really empathize with men's mental health or challenges, because most of them believe that men have the advantages due to patriarchy. Women think that men are not oppressed, and they have more freedom and entitlement. From biological point of view, it can be traced back to our cave-dweller ancestors. Men were providers. They hunted and brought back food. If they showed any emotion or weakness, nobody would follow them, and women would leave them, as strength was the only metric on which women selected their mates in prehistoric times. So men had no room to show any weakness. They had to endure it all on their own, and had to be the pillar of society. And this has still deep roots in the current society as well, even though we have modernized immensely. Women still do not want to be with a weak man. However, the metrics of measuring strength have changed from just raw strength to money and social status. Because back in the day it was survival of the fittest, and now it is survival of the richest. And women go where there is optimal chance of survival. Weak men lose respect from their peers and their family too. As a man is supposed to man up and deal with things with balls of steel. We have been fed phrases like, big boys don't cry, from our childhood. It is taboo for us to cry in public, and for a good reason. For a woman to get attention, all she has to do is post a crying selfie. But if a man does the same, then nobody cares, unless he is somebody. Thus the average men are the most neglected by society. Both emotionally and sexually. For men, there is a huge sword dangling on our heads, saying, be successful or be miserable. So what can we do about it, as we cannot just override our biological programming, nor can we change the mentality of women and society about it. One thing is out of question: that we must get rid of mediocrity. Because that is just the bottom of hell for men. So we have to strive to be better. Not just to gain respect of women and society, but to gain our own respect and raise our self-esteem past the sky. But to deal with the emotional baggage that comes with it and the pain and suffering. Men must confide in their male friends. Men must deal with this together. Now I know this is the hardest thing for a man, as we have been conditioned to never open our mouths about pain and suffering. But we got to do it every once in a while, or it will consume us internally. Find a friend that you trust and open up to him gradually, and not just dump only your emotional baggage on him. But listen to his pain too. But never ever dump it all at once. Layer by layer, share your pain as the trust builds, but you must let it out, or you will die an early death. But no matter what you do, never show emotional weakness to a woman. They claim that it is okay, but it's not. She will subconsciously lose respect for you, even if she pretends to be empathetic at the time. Only if you have been in a committed relationship, then you can open up a little. But tread very carefully. Women are hardwired biologically to find the strongest man attractive, and showing emotional weakness will chip away your attraction for her. These are the cards we are dealt with, so we got to play the game. Strive to be your best version with the least amount of emotional baggage. Find a male friend. Or just share it here. I will listen and I will reply. This channel is for you.